Hey everyone, just working a little bit on a page I started last night for a little bit. Give people a chance to come in if they have the their notifications set up. Hi Katrina. Welcome in. Bienvenue. Welcome. Good morning. There we go. Could be better, could be worse, Katrina. Life's kind of kicked my family in the teeth the last few days. There's a lot going on right now that I'm really kind of not in the mood to go into, but yeah. Yeah, until I know more about some of the stuff that's going on, it's probably best to just let you know that things are kind of up in the air, but this is from Johanna Basford's 2020 weekly coloring planner. I think this particular page might be from Secret Garden. I don't know. Thanks. It's been a lot. But yep, this is, for now, this is my therapy. Because, yeah, that's another shenanigan that's been going on. But anyway, how are you, Katrina? Yeah, there was a color palette on my Pinterest dash last night that I was just, it just really inspired me to figure out how to replicate it with my colored pencils. You're very welcome. But yeah, the last couple of days have been kind of busy. Friday, I spent most of the day on campus. I had a meeting with somebody and then a meetup with some friends. And then went straight from there to dinner with my family to celebrate my mom's birthday. Yeah, I have the previous one, the 1820 or no, 1819 one, but I don't know where it went. Where the heck did I put it? Because I colored the title page for that one, and I really like how it came out, so I want to show it off. I don't remember where I put it. Oh, there it is. It's all buried. Try not to cause an avalanche here. I did this one, yeah, September 18 to December 2019. I was, but I'm taking a semester off, because I didn't really give myself a chance to heal after my cancer treat, all of my cancer treatments, beginning of last year and pretty much all of 2018. And some things happened that made me reevaluate going back to school so soon. 'Cause like I finished my radiation on my right lung in like February. I had surgery on the left lung in January, and then in February I had radiation on the right lung, and then beginning of April I was back in school, and just never really slowed down. Like I took the first 5 weeks of the summer quarter off because there's 2 5-week sessions at my school over summer. So I took the first one off, but then I did 2 classes to kind of make up for that for the second session. And then between summer quarter and fall quarter, I drove out to Arizona to meet my best friend, or to meet up with my best friend. And then like 2 weeks before fall quarter started, I flew out to Virginia to see her again. So, yeah, I didn't really. Oh, yeah. I'm doing okay. I'm not completely in remission. There are still nodules in my lungs. So far, we've been taking a wait and see approach and doing scans on a fairly regular basis. So there's that. But we had gotten it to the point that I wasn't like under treatment for it. It was just keeping an eye on things. Yeah. I didn't really give myself a chance to heal. So my mind and my body let me know that that was a dumb thing to do, over fall quarter, and my grades slipped. And so it's kind of an involuntary break from school, but I'm not mad about it. Well, I'm mad at myself. I'm not mad at my school about it. 'Cause like I've told practically anybody I've talked to about it, I recognized the patterns I was falling into from pretty much my entire academic life, and I didn't do anything to stop it. Like I didn't talk to anybody about what I was doing, and I didn't ask for help. with keeping myself accountable. So, oh no, typos are 100% okay with me. Never need to apologize for typos. Oh yay, I'm up to 3 concurrent viewers. I'm hoping to keep to a fairly regular schedule for a while, so that will hopefully bring more people into my chats. Hey Jess, 1 second. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but I have some royalty-free music playing on my desktop to help me stay focused. Maybe fill the silence if I stop talking for a bit. Good, I'm glad you like it. I'm glad you like it. Oh, yes. I'm glad you like it. Jeez. Learn to talk, Danny. Back to Mr. Magpie. So this is my progress on Mr. Magpie. I think I'm going to use the colors that I used for... I've had my channel... Gosh, I think close to a year, actually. Yeah, I don't remember when my first video went up, but it's been pretty close to a year now. Train of thought, I had one, yes. Colors, I'm gonna try and match the colors in the leaves here on his body. If I can remember which ones I used. I think I may have used grass green. Yeah. I think I actually used those ones. And then that one was over here. Okay. So my plan is the leaves along the border are going to be the same color as the leaves on his neck, and then these little thingy whoppers, I don't know what they are, I'm gonna match, try and match to the ones on his, coming down from his beak. Really wish I could remember what colors I used for those. Oh well. Let's see. Yeah, I think what I'm gonna do is similar to these ones. Okay. And do the outside with the darker colors. Or maybe invert it. Do the darker colors inside and the lighter colors outside. Let me check my combo here first. Make sure I've got the right one. That looks about right. Okay. This one's got to be sharp. Sorry, you guys are gonna go for a ride for a little bit. I need to shift things up just a smidge. There we go. Just trying to keep my head out of the shot if I lean over to get a better view of what I'm doing. By the way, Jess, I went out to the kitchen earlier, and your darling boy was sitting on the edge of the peninsula by the cookie jar, just sitting there, and he saw me looking, and he just sat there and stared at me, like, yes, what you gonna do about it? Yep, he is a little snot.
Do I have sepia?
Yeah, right there. Just need a little bit more contrast here. You know, sometimes I kind of wonder how often it's actually Feely doing whatever is making noise. And we just assume that it's Shadow. Because experience has taught us that more often than not, it's Shadow. Right? Nope. Sorry, I've got my bracelet just a little bit too tight. That's better. We're gonna go for grass green for the base color for the middle part this time. Get that little bit of extra contrast in there. That was not the color I wanted for the shadows. Dang it! Threw myself off by moving my pencils around. This music is kind of reminding me of the Tron Legacy soundtrack. Kind of makes me want to listen to it. But that's not royalty free, so I can't right now. That's okay. I'll listen to it later. And we're back to another Daft Punky type song. Yay, welcome back. Thank you. I really like how the magpie came out. The colors just ended up working really well together. If you're wondering about the gray part here, it's because I scanned it from or copied it from my Johanna Basford coloring planner because I screwed up the one that was in the book. Well, I wouldn't say screwed up. I wasn't entirely satisfied with the colors I had chosen. So I just started over again because I knew I had another clean copy in my planner. Yeah, I think this might be one that I frame. Or gift to somebody. Yeah. Yeah, I'll have to remember to write down the color combos I used. If I can remember what they were. Yeah, I also have another coloring planner that I got off Amazon a couple years ago that I've done quite a bit of work in. A lot of it got done while I was in a chemo chair. Should have had more than Pop-Tarts for breakfast this morning. I'm already hungry. Oh well. Probably get a snack when I stretch my legs in a bit. Nice. Yeah, I did like the coloring planners, but Once I was back in school, there wasn't quite enough space for what I was looking for. I ended up finding the passion planner. The Disability Resource Center on campus got a bunch as part of their passion planners buy one, give one, or give one, get one, something like that. And so my first one was just a plain black one. And as Jess can tell you, that did not fit my personality at all. Jess is my sister, by the way. So, I ended up buying one of my own. And it's like a really pretty teal color. This is the one I got. And just, I really love how they're set up. Because you get the monthly, and there's like projects you can do, or projects you can write down, and then you get your weekly spread. I got the Johanna Basford ones off of Amazon. Just look up Johanna Basford planner, and you should be able to find it. And then, where's the other one? And then I bought this one. They also have coloring planners. I don't know if you're in the US or not, but they had them at Office Max. But the one thing I didn't like about the ones at Office Max was that they had like a monthly page, and then the weekly page was just, it was like the same pattern over and over again. There wasn't a lot of variety to it. So. Completed this one. And finished that one. Finished that one. But a lot of these ones were done with fine liners or gel pens, because those were a lot easier to take back and forth to the cancer center. And then once 2019 rolled around, I went looking for another one from this company because I really liked the style of it. And they didn't have a new one for 2019 at that point. So that's when I switched to the Johanna Basford. And then once I was back in school, I was just like, this isn't gonna fly. So back later. Where was I? Okay. But yeah, the thing I do like about the passion planner is that they're you can buy, you don't have to buy the planner to use it. Like, they have free downloads on their website, and if you don't mind spending the paper, you can just print them out yourself and put them in a binder. And they recently came out with a daily version. So, but that's a bit more than I really need. One of my friends has started using the daily. One second. Gotta let YouTube know I'm still listening. I'm sure there's a way to turn that off, but I haven't figured it out yet. But yeah, they seem to like the daily, and they're a friend through the Disability Resource Center at my school, and the disability specialist offered to get it printed and bound for them, and they really seem to like the daily passion planner. Which Nico, Jess? From Nico Okar or Nico Goldeneye from the Circle of Magic books? But yeah, as well as having the Passion Planner itself available. Yeah. They also have other downloadables to just make the Passion Planner work better for each person's individual needs. Like, they have a an assignment printable. They have habit trackers. What do you mean, Katrina? Oh, just Danny. It's in the channel name. Not to make you feel bad, but it's in my channel name. This is Discovering Coloring with Danny. I'm sorry. You're welcome. Yeah, the only thing I didn't, that kind of annoyed me about the Passion Planner is that there wasn't, they didn't have, like monthly tabs. And then, like, beginning of this year, they came out with monthly tabs that you could put in yourself. Oh, okay. And, I part of my resolution for this year is no spend 2020. Basically, the only things I can buy are like necessities, like groceries. For me, pedicures are a necessity because I can't, because of my cancer, I have limited mobility in my lower right leg. And so I can't take care of my right foot as well as necessary. So, and if I need to buy something that isn't like groceries or bills or pedicures, it has to be a one-to-one, replacement. Or, as near as you can get. The only exception I made was a new desktop because my desktop was getting kind of old. So I can't buy the monthly tabs for my Passion Planner. But what I've been doing was I use different color washi tape for each month. That way, it's easier to differentiate without the monthly tabs. And then, like anything I put into the planner for that month, I use that color washi tape to tape it in. Just you know, because the pages are a little bland, especially after using a coloring planner for like a year. So it's a nice way to kind of spiff things up a little bit. And another reason why I like to color code things when I put them in my planner. Just gives it a nice little zhuzh. You're welcome, Katrina. Thank you for coming in. If you could give me a thumbs up before you go, that would be awesome. I'd really appreciate that. Yeah, I liked the like customizability of doing the bullet journal, but I didn't enjoy the setup part so much. It felt like it ended up starting to feel like a chore. Which is not really conducive for ADHD minds to do something consistently, as you well know, Jess. Thank you. But I have actually kind of been thinking of picking it back up, but not as a planner. I was watching a video last week, a couple weeks ago. Someone was using it as a like a reading journal to keep track of their reading for the year. And I was thinking of doing that. Because, I mean, I do miss reading, like, actual books, like original fiction, rather than just all fan fiction all the time. Which, I mean, obviously, yeah, you know, there's nothing wrong with fan fiction. I just, sometimes you just want something new. You want a new world to explore and learn. Yeah. I'm thinking about adding a section for fanfic to the reading journal because I do read a lot of that. I just have to sit down and plan it, like what all I'm going to track and how I'm going to do it. Because I have the notebooks from my bullet journaling, and they're just sitting there, not doing anything. I also kind of want to develop a spread for my writing. Like, how many hours I've written, notebook pages, and then once I get it typed up, word count. Yeah, that's totally valid. Totally understand that. And like where I was when I was writing. Like, was I at home? Was I at the library? Was I at a coffee shop? See if there's certain places that make me more productive. Oh my gosh, Jess, I just got this amazing mental image. There was a Stabby the Space Roomba post that went across my Tumblr dash earlier, and I kind of want to write it into Jedi Besties. Like, they pick up a mouse droid for whatever reason, and it's not as timid. Hi, Candy! As most mouse droids. And somebody gets the idea of giving such a worthy warrior a fitting weapon and tapes the knife to him. And just shenanigans ensue. I kind of like the idea that nobody actually knows who put the knife on the mouse droid. Yes, yes. I kind of want it to be Kaizen that puts the knife on Stabby the mouse droid. But like, nobody, like, everybody who thinks, oh, maybe it was Kaizen, they're just like, nah. And Kaizen's just sitting back and enjoying the chaos that this little warrior is sowing among the crew. Like, I have this mental image of this little mouse droid encountering Kaizen, and like, Kaizen's in its way. And so, rather than go around Kaizen, it runs over his foot. And he's amused by the thing more than anything else. And just, yeah. And one of the posts in the thread was that Stabby assumes the rank of the person that he stabs, only going upwards, obviously, in rank. So, like, he starts out as, like, a private, and when he gets a lieutenant, he gets promoted to lieutenant. When he gets a captain, he gets promoted to a captain, etc. Like, all the way up to flag admiral. And I'm just imagining him getting Master Satil. So he elevates to the rank of Jedi Grandmaster. trying not to laugh too much at the mental images going through my head of Stabby the Mouse Droid. Like, it gets Alte, and Kaizen starts calling it, Harold. And Nadia thinks it's the best thing ever, so she starts calling it Barsenthor. Barsenthor Stabby. If I wasn't streaming right now, I would write this down in our notes. And then it gets May, and they call it Battlemaster, and Hunter, and Hero of Tython, even though he's never been, actually been on Tython, which leads them to take him to Tython. And the Padawans love him. I think he's the best thing ever. To me, it seemed like mouse droids were largely in the Empire. I don't remember seeing... Yeah, exactly. That's the chance to stab Satele. I don't remember seeing any in the Republic. So that makes me think that, like... Tayrund, Ashara, or Vort are the ones that get him, that get Stabby. Because they're just like, they were so cute, and I kind of miss the little things. Oh my gosh, can you imagine Stabby the Mouse Droid on the Alliance base? With all the different type of people, all the different personalities. Yeah. Kira repairs it, and then Theron is actually the one that reprograms it a little bit, so it's not quite as timid as most mouse droids. And then it runs into Kaizen. My brain sometimes is amazing. Yeah. Like Kira finds it somehow and mentions that she remembers them from when she was in the Empire, and she always felt bad that they were so timid. And they weren't treated very well by the some of the her fellow students at this the Sith Academy. So she reprograms it. Like maybe Vort kept the mouse droid because it was one of the few things in the Empire he actually liked. But like when he's when his things are being searched, it accidentally gets damaged and stops working. So he's trying to fix it himself, and He has it like out on a table or something. One of the times that Theron comes by his apartment on the fleet, trying to figure out how to fix it. And Theron offers to see if he can do anything with it. And then Kira finds him working on it. And it just snowballs from there. That's something that Tyrion and Vort end up bonding over. Like they get to talking, and one of them's like, "Is there anything you actually miss about being in the Empire?" And the other one's mentions the mouse droids, which is completely random. They're just like, "Actually, I kind of like those little mouse droids." And then Vort remembers that he had brought a mouse droid with him. And goes to find it, and then finds out that it's broken. This story is getting way more plotty than I originally intended. It's just supposed to be like comedic shenanigans. I think once I finish these leaves, I'm gonna take a break for a little bit, get up and stretch my legs, have a snack. Because I've been at this about. Right? Oh, the folly of men. I'm a reasonably intelligent person. I can do this. Nope. Like, he even looks up how-to guides on the holonet and nope, still can't figure it out. Okay. Time for a bit of a break. Almost knocked some stuff over. I'm gonna mute my microphone while I'm away from my desk, so I will be right back. I'll be back in about 5 minutes. Okay. Done eating, so we can unmute the mic. Because I doubt anybody wanted to hear that. I would skip this song because it's super annoying, but it's across the room. Not me getting up. Thank you. Hey Jess, could you look up what gâteau means in French? I think it's cake, but for some reason it's niggling at my brain to get that translated. Yeah. Okay, that's what I thought. I watched a few episodes of Great British Bake Off last night.
Thank you.
Getting there with the leaves. Thanks. Gotta let go, let YouTube know I'm still listening.
Yes.
Making me wish my mouse on my desktop was wireless, so I could just bring it over here. Oh, shisa. Hang on. Skipping this one again. I think for next time I'm just going to, I have some, music on my laptop in a playlist that I think I'm gonna put on my desktop so I don't have to get annoyed at YouTube every half hour. While my family was at dinner Friday night, my oldest sister, not Jess, the one that's in the chat right now, but her twin, Jess's twin, warned me away from diamond painting. Because she's gotten into it, and she's just like, you do not want to get sucked into this. And I'm like, oh, believe me. I've known about diamond painting, and I knew that it was something that I needed to stay far away from. Because that is entirely too much temptation for myself and for Jess's cat. Because there's all those little crystals that can get lost and moved around. I'm just like, nope. But she sent the family, after she talked to us about it on Friday, she sent the family a picture of the painting that she had finished. It's super pretty. It's a blue dahlia. I haven't been on Instagram yet today to see if she's posted it on there yet. But I told her if she tagged it, diamond painting, that she'd probably get a lot of, likes. Like, I've kind of looked at diamond painting kits, but that's a lot of fiddly bits for me. And my mom started looking a little bit as well, but she has carpal tunnel, like super bad. So she's like, they're pretty, but I don't need something else to add to the strain on my hands. And I was just like, yeah, same. And I'm kind of running out of storage space in my room, so that's another good reason not to get into it. If I had a craft room that I could just shut off and keep a certain troublemaker out, I might be even more tempted, but right now I'm just like, yeah, I'm happy with my coloring and my crocheting and attempts at knitting. Although I have considered giving sewing another try. Now that I have the ADHD under control. Okay. That's those leaves done. I am determined to finish this page today. Okay. Oops. Nope. I need those. These are the ones I want to put aside.
Thank you.
Okay. As much as I would love to keep going on this, the mind is willing, but the body is getting older. My back is letting me know that I've been bent over this for too long. But made a lot of good progress on this. I'm really happy with it so far. I think I'm gonna try and finish this in the next couple of days, and then on Wednesday we'll start on a new picture for hashtag flying into 2020. So thanks for coming, everybody that popped in. Thanks for staying for the whole time, Jess. See you later. Bye. If I can get my mouse to work. Did my batteries die?